Welcome to the channel. Like and subscribe. Make sure you listen to the full-length podcast episodes every other Wednesday, wherever you listen to podcasts. Now check out a clip from our latest episode, Be a Man. Be a Man.
Experience! We drink because it's what men do.
When you were a kid, right, did your old man drink booze in the house?
He said, my parents weren't drinkers. They drink wine.
Oh, okay.
My old man drink wine. My mother maybe has some Baileys.
My old man drank whiskey.
Yeah.
And whiskey was not his friend. Highballs, you know, Seagram's, Canadian Club.
Yeah.
Wasn't too much beer around.
I always drank when I was younger, though. Like, I can, as long as I can remember, I was always having a little wine.
Oh, yeah.
They always give you a taste.
Yeah, back then, the father, the mother, they would let the kid taste the whiskey.
Yeah.
And I'm sorry. Even to this day, as I was thinking, it tastes like shit to me. I'll drink it. It ain't chocolate milk.
Yeah.
It ain't fucking like a parfait. You know, I'll drink it, but I can't honestly say I enjoy the taste so much.
You gotta put it on the rocks.
You're not drinking for taste. Don't be such babies.
Yeah, I drink for one reason. Let's be honest. I drink to get fucked up.
Absolutely.
How about you?
I'm not doing it for fun. I want to get fucked up, for sure.
I mean, seriously, if I'm going to fucking drink something, How about a Coke or a glass of fucking Bosco or cocoa?
Yeah.
Oh, give me a nice, refreshing Yukon Jack.
Yeah.
Come on. That's not going to do it. You know, we had this neighbor. He was in trouble with the wife. He was holding his 2-year-old son in his arms at this time, for real, rocking the baby, totally shit-faced, telling me how his wife is breaking his balls because he was given the 5-year-old beer.
Sick.
In the midst of this story, he drops the 2-year-old right on a marble floor. The poor kids. Fast forward, there's a possibility that the booze affected them.
Yeah. All the drop
know.
In the head.
Be a man.
When I get to junior high, we take off sometimes up in the richer part of town. We hang out with kids. Their parents would be working. We go in there, raid the liquor cabinet.
Yeah.
We're drinking during the day. We get a little water and fill up the fucking the booze we took, you know?
Oh, yeah, of course.
Yeah.
Liquor cabinet.
Yeah. Do you guys remember the first time that you vomited due to overdrinking?
Yeah, I think I do. I think I was 14.
I was eight.
No, I think I was like 14.
The most violent memory I have of puking is probably not the first time, was Somerville High School, drinking Southern Comfort.
Yeah,
that seems to be a big one with a lot of people.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. What will you never drink again? Many people will say Southern Comfort.
Yeah.
Right.
Well, once you get sick on something.
That's it.
I think I got sick in that once. And
yeah.
I don't. Jack Daniels, too.
Gin.
Wild turkey.
I don't mind gin.
Be a man.
You know what you don't see guys doing anymore, speaking of drinking, and I think they should bring it back? A nice flask. Picture this. You're at a business meeting, at a lunch, boardroom, whatever. You have your suits on. In the middle of a presentation, you casually reach in and break open your flask. In front of everybody. They stand there aghast. And you go, oh, I'm sorry. And you offer them some. Take a swig. You put it back. And go, you were saying.
What a tone setter.
Come on.
That is, as like as a personal prop, like no man should be without one.
No.
Yeah. Be a man.
When I was at school, me and some of the punks I hung out with, we fucking broke into all kinds of like little farm stands, fucking taking like 40-pound pumpkins or whatever we could steal. Then we pull over, we see a bunch of cows. So we pull over, they're like, let's go cow tipping. So we jumped into the pen with the cows. Shit face out of our minds, moonlight, you could see him just standing there. It works.
Romantic.
It was like, boom, smack, right? So all
did
of a sudden,
they make the sound like the,
Probably. The sound I remember is them hitting the ground like, boom. It was like
do they get back up or not?
Well, I climbed out. I was near a fence, so I got the fuck out of there. But it was fucking crazy.
Be a man.
So, of course, there's the bar scene, but then, like, you know, you get a little bit older, and then there's the club scene. Were you guys into it?
Yeah.
Were you guys pulling broads
totally
out of dance clubs and
girls? Of course, we're into it.
Put it this way. You know, like, I was banging cocktail waitresses 2 at a time. Like Mo Green says about Fredo. Don't forget, I came of age in late... mid-70s onwards.
A couple of years behind you.
I had a lot of action.
Yeah, disco time. Was
Free love, baby, was going around.
We used to go to different clubs, wherever the broads were, and it was dancing.
Yeah.
You know, I worked as a bouncer in, you know, Saugus and Revere and Lynn, too, so I used to meet a lot of broads that way.
Yeah.
But I used to go, as far as, you know, going to different clubs. It was just to meet girls.
Have you ever won a woman off of the dance floor? Like, just kind of, like, locked eyes and then Absolutely. Started dancing and then fucking ended up fucking sealing the deal?
That's what we should do all the time.
Wow.
I go ask abroad to dance and you end up having a drink with her and you fucking pick her up that night or take her on a date later or whatever. You know, that's how you meet broads.
Fucking, you know. Wow. I will never know that really? Kind of erotic.
That you missed it.
That never existed right? for you?
No, well,
that's
maybe,
how it was done,
maybe
John,
because
back
I,
in the day, right?
Maybe because Absolutely. I had no fucking game and I couldn't fucking dance and I had no fucking confidence.
Be a man.
Before you go out with all your buddies and you go out for a night of drinking, there's always the make it or break it moment, the pregame. Did you guys ever get into heavy with the pregame?
Oh, you can't, even, you can't report for the game.
Be down someone's basement fucking getting hammered at like, you know, 2 or 3 in the afternoon, getting ready. Watching a game on like a Saturday, watching college football, whatever.
Yeah, and then going out for last call.
They just go out and tear it up.
Sometimes the pregame was worse than the actual game. Sometimes I had to sit the game out.
Yeah,
sometimes people didn't make it to the game.
Yeah, you don't make it.
Drank too much early.
I always preferred the pregame so much when it came to the point where it was like, let's go to the game. I was always like, maybe I'll just fucking see it. Yeah.
I'm that way with real games when I used to last go to games. Like my last, say, football game I went to, I said, fuck this. I'm going back to the wagon outside. I don't care about the fucking game. Yeah, sat on the car drinking. That's where the booze and all the shit was.
Yeah.
Right? I mean, I don't need to see the fucking game in any capacity.
Yeah.
The pregame and your own game is where it's at.
A little tailgating.
Tailgate.
Yeah.
Be a man.
If you don't drink, all your stories suck. It's the absolute truth. Like, if you don't, there's no good stories that come out of, oh, I was dead sober and this fucking thing happened. All the best stories start from drinking. And, like, Absolutely. All the funnest stories and all the best times, you always associate it with drinking, right?
100%.
Yeah.
Guys that don't drink, how about when you go out with a guy that they really they don't drink at all, and you notice there's no stories from those nights at all, ever, right?
Don't trust them.
At least you got a designated driver.
Right.
Never trust a man that doesn't drink.
So I hope you enjoyed the
Be a Man experience.